Very good morning and warm welcome to my dear sweet little children. Welcome to digital learning. Today we'll study subject English, unit 3, lesson number 23, computers. Dear children, as if you all are well versed with what computer is, how it is operate, how you operate the computers, right? Because you have your computer as a subject, right? But still, we are going to learn something new and something that we already know in this lesson. Let's begin by reading the lesson first. First, we'll read the lesson and then we will try to understand it paragraph wise. Are you ready for it? Let's begin with it then. Please open page number 51. Page number 51, lesson number 23, computers. You have learnt the mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You can do sums which involve any one or more of these operations. You may also solve complicated sums which involve all of these operations. You can calculate the answers quickly if you use tables. But sometimes it is necessary to carry out very complicated calculations that involve very large numbers. At such times, mistakes are bound to occur in the calculations. Then you waste a lot of time checking and rechecking your answers. How can we avoid these errors and wastage of time? A computer is a machine that is an answer to all these problems. Computers can also solve problems and carry out the most difficult calculations with amazing speed and accuracy. Computers can do several other things besides carrying out calculations. In fact, there are few things that a modern computer is not able to do. Computers have memory, that is, they can store a lot of data or information. They can keep words, pictures and sounds in their memory and give you the information within a fraction of a second when you need it. Computers can process the data or the information according to the instructions given to them. A modern computer can follow thousands of instructions within a fraction of a second. Only the instructions have to be given in a language that the computer understands. A set of code instructions written for a computer is known as a program. Writing a computer program is a specialized task. Please turn the page. A computer on its own does not make judgments about the instructions given to it. It follows the instructions blindly. That is why the instructions have to be written very carefully. The instructions must cover every step involved in an operation. If you miss a step, the computer will not correct it. One has to think carefully to imagine every step involved in any task. Let us see if we can imagine all the steps involved in a simple task. Suppose mother has asked you to buy vegetables. You have to divide this task into smaller ones. Going to a greengrocer's shop, picking up the vegetables you want and paying for them, coming back home. Then you have to subdivide these tasks into still smaller ones. For example, going to the greengrocer's shop, take a bag for the vegetable, take money for the vegetable. Start from your home, walk down the street, turn right or left, walk down the street, cross the street, enter greengrocer's shop. Each of these smaller tasks can again be divided further into even smaller tasks. Try to do that choosing any one of the above steps. Thus, we see that the computers are smarter than men. But it is men who do the difficult job of making them smart enough. So the next time you play a game on your computer or watch a video or obtain some information, think of the men who put in so many efforts to make it all possible. Dear children, this is a small piece of information related to computer. I know you all are very well versed with computers now. Now, let's try to understand the lesson paragraph wise. So, again we will move to page number. Lesson number 23, Computers, our first paragraph. You have learned the mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplications, and division. Dear children, addition, subtraction, multiplication is what? Your mathematical operations, right? We have learned how to use, how to do this mathematical operations. Now, we can solve sums which involve such kind of mathematical operation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Yes? You may also solve complicated sums which involve all of these operations. Yes? We can solve all the complicated, means difficult sums, which involve means to include someone or something. Okay? Which includes. Okay? Involve means which includes these operations. You can calculate the answers quickly if you use tables. If we use tables, we can also calculate answers very quickly. Addition and multiplication is one and the same. Yes? Then one and the same means number, when one digit is multiplied to the same number many number of times, multiplication, we can make use of multiplication and we can quickly find the answer. Yes? So, we can quickly find the answers using tables. But sometimes it is necessary to carry out very complicated calculations that involve very large numbers. But sometimes the sums are little complicated. Yes? Means difficult. Okay? Over there, number of calculations has to be done to find the answer. Then we have to waste lot of time checking and rechecking the answer. We need to check the answers again and again. If a small mistake occurs in that, then we have to check our answer. We have to do the calculations, recalculate it, right? To avoid these errors and wastage of time, we have a machine called computer. Yes, a computer is a machine that is answer to all these problems. Yes, so computer is a machine that answers all the problems. Is answer to all the problems. It can solve problems quickly. Yes, on computers we can solve most difficult calculations with amazing speed and accuracy. The main thing is accuracy, means you will not get wrong answer and you will get answer within fraction of seconds. So computer can calculate fast and it has accuracy. Accuracy means exactness, means correctness. Amazing speed means astounding. Amazing speed is astonishing. Okay? Computers can do several other things besides carrying out calculations. Not only calculations, it can do several means many other things. In fact, there are very few few things that a modern computer is not able to do. If we overall compare, modern computer can only a few things are impossible by modern computers. Our computers can do n number of things. Only a few number of things that a computer cannot do. Computers also have memory. That is, they can store a lot of data or information. Data means information. Okay? It can store lot of information in it. They can keep words, pictures and sounds in their memory and give you the information within a fraction of a second when you need it. They store information. It can be word, it can be pictures, it can be sound, it can be anything they store in them. And you can just type in a search bar and you can search for any information that you have feeded in your computer, or you can make use of internet and you can get any piece of information when you type about that information, the topic in the search bar, you will get within fraction of second. Okay? The information is displayed on the screen within a fraction of second. Let's move on. Computers can process the data or information according to the instructions given to them. But the thing is, dear children, computer does not work on our own, because we can work on our own, but computers cannot. We need to give them instructions and they follow that instructions and then they work accordingly. A modern computer can follow thousands of instructions within a fraction of a second. And it can surprise you. This piece of information can surprise you that, dear children, it follows thousands of instructions at a time. And within a fraction of a second, it gives you a result for your instructions. Only the instructions have to be given in a language that the computer understands. Computer has a separate language. The way we have English, Hindi, Marathi, computer has command language. Yes, and computer can only follow this command language of its. Okay, we have to give command to the computer and then only it can understand the instructions. A set of code instructions written for a computer is known as a program. Code means a system of words, letters, numbers or symbols that record information in a shorter form. Code means a system of words, letters, numbers or symbols that record information in a shorter form. Okay, words, letters, numbers, they are recorded in small, shorter form. That is called as code. Okay. And set of code, 2-3 codes together make a program. Okay. Writing a computer program is a specialized task. Specialized means which have special knowledge of a particular subject. Specialized means having a special knowledge of a particular subject. So, the one who writes the program for a computer is not a very simple task. It's a very specialized work, means different, and the person with good knowledge of computer can only do this task. Now, dear children, we'll stop here only. Remaining part of the lesson we'll study tomorrow. I hope this much part is clear to you. I'll be sending you few notes in the form of PDF. Okay. So, that's all for today, my dear children. Thank you for watching. Take care. Meet you tomorrow in our next lecture. Stay home. Be safe. Keep responding and keep subscribing our channel. Bye.